so great to be back in this beautiful place. And what an amazing venue. Please do take a seat. We won't make you stand for the whole thing. There'll be more opportunities to dance and have a good time. You can rest those legs. This is an old one. You guys are going to know this one. Good friends of the guy called Sam Palladio. Do you guys know him? Yeah. He's a very handsome man, I know.
Yeah. Oh, he's amazing, Sam.
But he, for those of you who don't know, he plays Gunner in the TV show Nashville. And we were out in town, and he bumped into this guy at a show. This guy tapped him on the shoulder and said, they kind of knew each other. And then the guy said to him, I'm playing a show tomorrow in town. Do you want to come down? And Sam was like, yeah, cool, where are you playing? And he's like, the Bridgestone Arena, which is like 20,000 people. Oh, it's the second biggest venue. in the whole of Nashville. And Sam was like, yeah, cool, I'll come down. So Sam calls us and says, I've got 4 tickets to the show tomorrow. Do you guys want to go? And we're like, yeah, cool, who's playing? It's like, Ed Sheeran. So we're like, yeah, we could find some time for that, Sam. So yeah, we went along to the show. The show was amazing. The after party, and that was kind of legendary.
From what we remember, anyway. There's no photos allowed to be taken.
I mean, thank God, there's no photos. I remember I turned around halfway through the party, I see this girl upside down over a beer keg, being held up by the air, drinking beer from the spout. So I thought, it's a lot like Chrissy. That is Chrissy. Anyway, long story short, Ed sent this song. This is called Stay the Night. Heart is like an ocean. I wanna dive into you. Your love is like a river that I'm swimming through. Somehow I found someone who truly loves me.
Brighton, do we know what night of the week it is? song. It's Friday night, right? Yeah. I don't know, we're on tour, we don't know what day it is, so let's put some Friday night up in here right now. Come on, let's see what we do.
We do what I gotta do, yeah. It's a day like a deja vu. My day. It's no fun, always something that's gotta be done. Can't you see I just wanna feel young?
Oh, that's nice, isn't it? This next song is the title track of our brand new album. It's called Accidentally On Purpose. It was one of the last songs that Ben and I actually wrote for this album, back when we were out in Nashville in October. Yes. I happened to meet a nice man out there. I know, right? We were hanging out quite a bit when we were there. Ben and I were writing in the daytime, and then we were all hanging out in the evening. Even Ben approved of him. Hanging out and up together. You know, I need to get his approval, obviously. So it came to the very last writing session. We were meant to be leaving the next morning, getting on the airplane and off back home. And I came into that writing session, and I turned to Ben and to Jimmy, our co-writer, and I said, I don't know, I've just been having such a lovely time over here and I just don't really want to leave just yet. You know, maybe I could just stay a little longer and just maybe get to know this guy a little bit more, maybe. And little did I know that everything that I was saying, this guy over here was just typing.
I mean, I was kind of listening. I think Chrissy needed that sympathetic friend and I was just kind of like, yeah, I don't know what you should do, Chrissy, I'm not sure, but just keep talking. Everything Chrissy was saying is some perfect lyrics.
We wrote everything down, put a little melody to it, and that became this song, Accidentally On Purpose.
Yeah.
didn't work out. I did stay accidentally on purpose, though.
I think that song is actually older than the whole length of that relationship.
We got a good song out of it, you know.
Our love is like lightning, it's beautiful, it's frightening sometimes. But if we're together, whatever the weather, we'll find shelter. Thank you.
You know, those songs just take us right back. Right back to the very start of Ben and I, the Shires. Brave and Black and White were the very first songs that he ever sent to me on email. And I remember listening to Black and White and getting about halfway through and just being absolutely floored at how amazing that song was. And I was just, straight away, I was like, yes, I'm up for this. I was so grateful and excited that I found a songwriter just like Ben. I mean, this guy, look at that guy. Ballads, and we couldn't believe that we found each other, another friend that loved ballads. But that was a while ago, I think it was like 5 years ago, I think we've been together. Was that right, darling? That is a lot happened in those years, but most importantly, that Ben has had two little babies. I have no idea where he found the time.
Yeah.
But, we had a little Tennessee and River are here. And when Ben found out that he was going to be a dad for the very first time, he wrote a song about everything that he wanted to give to his little one, what he wanted to be as a dad, and the influence of his dad in his life as well. And strangely, at the exact same time, without knowing, I also wrote a song about my dad. And my dad passed away from cancer when I was just 8 years old, so I didn't get that long with him, but from what I remember, he was a wonderful man. My family and I, we always struggled to talk about him, and I think that was just the way that we kind of, you know, dealt with the grief of it. But having this song has helped me to open up, and also my family. You know, his name is mentioned so much more in our household now, and I really do believe that music can be therapy and can help you through so many difficult times in your lives. And I hope that you guys out there can feel that as well with our music. So this is Daddy's Little Girl.
Oh,
So beautiful seeing that, honestly, you know, it's perfect for the song as well. It's all that sleepwalking and you can just imagine the stars in the video and stuff. Thank you, it's just beautiful.